They are scared of an independent black man who's not controlled by any white person, who's not controlled by London.
The West controls many African organizations. Whenever the time comes to help Africa, they fail because it is never their agenda. What should nations do when an organization fails to fulfill its promises? Perhaps expelling the organization would be the best course of action. ECOWAS, initially abandoned by three African nations, ultimately proved useless. The three nations, Niger, Mali, and Burkina Faso, asserted that ECOWAS is a flawed organization incapable of assisting, but their claims were initially met with skepticism. Recently, ECOWAS failed to offer a solution to the Senegal crisis, further confirming its ineffectiveness. So, will more nations withdraw from ECOWAS now? Let's find out. ECOWAS, the Economic Community of West African States, has recently decided to withdraw its interference in Senegal's internal affairs. Why is ECOWAS withdrawing its interference in Senegal? This decision comes amidst a growing debate surrounding the perception that the organization might be overstepping its designated role. The move raises questions about the necessity of external intervention in the internal matters of member states and the potential impact on diplomatic relationships. Experts argue that the nation possesses a robust judicial system capable of addressing internal disputes without external interference. They contend that the intervention might be unnecessary and even counterproductive. The withdrawal decision prompts a closer examination of the reasons behind ECOWAS's initial involvement and the considerations that led to this significant policy shift. What were the reasons behind ECOWAS's initial involvement in Senegal's internal affairs? Various factors drove ECOWAS's initial involvement in Senegal's internal affairs. The organization, established to promote economic integration and political stability among West African states, has historically intervened in member states facing political unrest or internal conflicts. In the case of Senegal, there were likely concerns about potential human rights violations, threats to political stability, or other issues that warranted ECOWAS's attention. It is crucial to delve into the specific circumstances that led ECOWAS to intervene in Senegal. Understanding the initial reasons behind the interference can illuminate the organization's priorities and the challenges it perceives in member states' internal affairs. The perception of overstepping its designated role plays a significant role in ECOWAS's decision to withdraw from Senegal's internal affairs. As the organization involves itself in member states' internal matters, questions arise about the extent to which ECOWAS should interfere. Experts argue that the organization might be overreaching its mandate and potentially undermining the sovereignty of member states. The withdrawal signals a responsiveness to these concerns and a willingness to reassess the balance between intervention and respecting the autonomy of member states. How does the debate on external intervention impact relationships with member states? The debate on external intervention, particularly in the context of ECOWAS's withdrawal from Senegal, has implications for diplomatic relationships with member states. Critics of the intervention assert that such actions can strain relationships, as member states may perceive ECOWAS as interfering unnecessarily in their internal affairs. The withdrawal may be an attempt to mitigate potential tensions and reaffirm the principle of non-interference in the domestic affairs of member states. A central argument against ECOWAS's intervention in Senegal is the contention that the nation's judicial system is well equipped to address internal disputes. Experts argue that external intervention may be unnecessary and undermine the effectiveness of Senegal's legal institutions. Examining the capabilities and limitations of Senegal's judicial system is crucial in understanding the rationale behind ECOWAS's withdrawal. It raises questions about the balance between regional oversight and the autonomy of member states in handling internal matters. Is external intervention counterproductive in addressing internal disputes? Here's a reminder to please like and share the video and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos on Black culture, history, civilization, and identity. Let's continue now. The withdrawal of ECOWAS from Senegal's internal affairs prompts a broader question about the effectiveness of external intervention in addressing internal disputes. Such interference may be counterproductive, potentially exacerbating tensions and undermining local institutions. Analyzing past instances of external intervention and their outcomes can provide insights into the challenges faced by regional organizations when attempting to mediate internal conflicts. It also prompts a reflection on the appropriate role of external actors in facilitating conflict resolution within member states. But what has happened in Senegal, and what is behind the violent protests? Senegal has recently experienced significant events that have sparked violent protests. The primary catalyst for these demonstrations was the postponement of presidential elections, which has raised widespread discontent and skepticism among the population. Initially, peaceful rallies were organized to denounce the decision to delay the elections. However, these gatherings were met with a heavy security presence, exacerbating tensions. The response from the police included the use of aggressive tactics, including firearms, leading to the apprehension of demonstrators. To comprehend the dynamics behind the violent protests, it is crucial to delve into the reasons behind the postponement of the elections and the subsequent actions by both the government and the protesters. Why were the presidential elections in Senegal postponed, and what triggered the decision? The decision to postpone the presidential elections in Senegal is a critical factor contributing to violent protests. Understanding the reasons behind this postponement sheds light on the political landscape and the factors that have fueled discontent among the population. Various factors were behind the decision to delay the elections, ranging from logistical challenges to concerns about the electoral process's fairness and transparency. Investigating the specific reasons provided by the Senegal government for the postponement is essential in comprehending the context that has given rise to the current unrest. How did peaceful rallies transform into violent protests? Initially, the response to the postponement of presidential elections in Senegal took the form of peaceful rallies organized to express public discontent. However, these gatherings took a turn towards violence as a result of several contributing factors. One key factor is the heavy security presence that met the peaceful protesters. The use of force by the police, including aggressive tactics and the deployment of firearms, escalated tensions and transformed the nature of the demonstrations. Examining the sequence of events leading from peaceful rallies to violent protests provides insights into the dynamics of the interaction between the government and the protesting population. What role did the heavy security presence play in escalating tensions? The heavy security presence in response to the peaceful rallies significantly escalated tensions in Senegal. The use of force by the police, including aggressive tactics and the deployment of firearms, created an atmosphere of hostility and resistance among the protesters. The decision to postpone the presidential elections in Senegal has triggered protests and fueled widespread discontent and skepticism among the population. The population's skepticism is rooted in concerns about the transparency and fairness of the electoral process. Additionally, the postponement may be viewed as a threat to the democratic principles that underpin Senegal's governance structure. The use of firearms and the apprehension of demonstrators by the police have had a significant impact on the nature and intensity of the protests in Senegal. The aggressive tactics employed by the security forces have not only escalated tensions, but also led to the arrest of individuals participating in the demonstrations. How is ECOWAS handling the crisis in Senegal? Was withdrawing the right decision? The crisis in Senegal has drawn attention to the role of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS, in managing political unrest within its member states. In the case of Senegal, ECOWAS appears to be handling the crisis by adopting a cautious approach, marked by a noticeable cessation of communication regarding the situation in the country. This approach suggests a departure from the organization's earlier interventions in crises in Mali, Burkina Faso, and Niger. ECOWAS's handling of the crisis in Senegal is characterized by a conspicuous cessation of communication regarding the situation. The organization seems to be refraining from making public statements, or taking explicit positions on the events unfolding in Senegal. This lack of communication raises questions about the factors influencing ECOWAS's decision to adopt a more reserved stance in this crisis. A notable aspect of ECOWAS's handling of the crisis in Senegal is the apparent shift from direct intervention in member states' electoral process and internal affairs. Previous instances, such as interventions in Mali, Burkina Faso, and Niger, showcased a more active role in mediating political crises. The current approach suggests a departure from this proactive stance, prompting an exploration of the reasons behind ECOWAS's decision to adopt a more hands-off approach in Senegal. Several factors have influenced ECOWAS's decision to refrain from direct intervention in the crisis in Senegal. These include a reassessment of the effectiveness of previous interventions, concerns about overstepping the organization's mandate, or a desire to respect the sovereignty of member states. Comparing ECOWAS's approach to the crisis in Senegal with its earlier involvement in Mali, Burkina Faso, and Niger reveals a noticeable difference in strategy. While the organization actively intervened in the mentioned countries, it seems to have adopted a more cautious and hands-off approach in Senegal. The cautious approach adopted by ECOWAS in handling the crisis in Senegal raises questions about the broader implications for regional stability in West Africa. Regional organizations often play a crucial role in maintaining peace and stability among member states. ECOWAS's decision to refrain from direct intervention in Senegal prompts examining how this approach may impact the organization's credibility and ability to address regional political crises. Analyzing whether ECOWAS's current approach to the crisis in Senegal aligns with its mandate and principles is crucial in understanding the organization's decision-making process. Regional organizations typically operate within defined frameworks, and assessing the consistency of ECOWAS's actions with its established principles provides insights into the challenges such entities face when navigating complex political landscapes. What is the stance of ECOWAS leaders regarding Senegal, especially after the recent meeting in Abuja? The recent meeting of ECOWAS leaders in Abuja has brought attention to the organization's stance on the situation in Senegal. Notably, the leaders refrained from addressing questions related to Senegal during the meeting, suggesting a potential shift in their stance. Avoiding discussing Senegal indicates a reluctance to continue intervening in the country's electoral process and internal affairs, hinting at a departure from their previous hands-on approach. How significant is the avoidance of questions related to Senegal during the recent ECOWAS leaders' meeting? The avoidance of questions related to Senegal during the recent ECOWAS leaders' meeting holds significance in understanding the organization's current stance on the crisis. Such avoidance suggests a deliberate decision by ECOWAS leaders to sidestep discussions about the situation in Senegal, raising questions about the factors influencing this shift in approach. Comparing the recent avoidance of questions related to Senegal with ECOWAS's historical approach to political crises in member states provides context to the potential shift in stance. ECOWAS has traditionally played an active role in addressing political unrest within its member states, making the recent avoidance a departure from its established pattern. One thing is clear: ECOWAS didn't think of anything else and withdrew from Senegal because of the crisis. So, let's talk about the crisis in detail and if this can impact Senegal even more. Let's start with how the Senegal government is responding to the crisis. In the face of the crisis triggered by the postponement of elections, the Senegal government, led by President Sall, has adopted a specific response strategy. President Sall justifies the election delay by highlighting the necessity for additional time to address contentious issues, including candidate disqualifications and institutional conflicts. Furthermore, he proposes a national dialogue to rebuild trust and foster inclusivity before rescheduled elections. Despite these assurances, widespread skepticism regarding the president's intentions persists among the population. How does President Sall justify the election delay? And what issues does he highlight? President Sall justifies the election delay by emphasizing the need for additional time to address specific contentious issues within the electoral process. Among the highlighted issues are candidate disqualifications and institutional conflicts. President Sall proposes a national dialogue to address the crisis in Senegal as part of the government's response strategy. The national dialogue is a platform to rebuild trust and foster inclusivity before rescheduled elections. Exploring the details of this proposed dialogue, including its structure, participants, and intended outcomes, provides insights into how the government envisions it as a tool for resolving the crisis and restoring political stability. President Sall has offered assurances to alleviate concerns and rebuild trust amid the crisis. These assurances may include commitments to address specific issues, transparency in the electoral process, and a pledge to engage in a national dialogue. Examining the nature of these assurances and their alignment with the concerns raised by the population is crucial in evaluating the effectiveness of the government's efforts to restore confidence in the political system. Despite President Sall's assurances and proposed initiatives, widespread skepticism regarding his intentions persists among the population. Investigating the factors contributing to this skepticism is essential in understanding the disconnect between the government's narrative and the public's perception. It will involve examining historical precedents, the credibility of past government actions, and the perceived alignment of the proposed measures with the genuine concerns of the citizens. President Sall identifies candidate disqualifications and institutional conflicts as key issues contributing to the crisis in Senegal. Is there anything apart from this that Senegal is dealing with? What are the socioeconomic challenges in Senegal contributing to the crisis? Senegal grapples with profound socioeconomic challenges that play a pivotal role in contributing to the ongoing crisis. These challenges encompass economic disparities, with a high poverty rate of 36.3%, fostering feelings of disillusionment and discontent, particularly among the youth. The interplay of economic, political, and religious elites further exacerbates the situation, rendering the population more susceptible to unrest amid perceived injustices. How does the high poverty rate of 36.3% contribute to the crisis in Senegal? The high poverty rate of 36.3% in Senegal is a crucial socioeconomic factor contributing to the crisis. Understanding the impact of poverty on the population provides insights into the challenges citizens face, such as limited access to necessities, education, and healthcare. In what ways are the youth in Senegal particularly affected by socioeconomic challenges? The youth in Senegal are particularly affected by socioeconomic challenges, including economic disparities and a high poverty rate. Exploring how these challenges impact the youth, such as limited job opportunities, inadequate educational resources, and a lack of prospects for upward mobility, provides insights into the factors driving discontent among this demographic. How are international observers and experts reacting to the situation in Senegal? Internationally, the situation in Senegal has prompted growing concerns and responses from international observers and experts. Calls for tangible steps, including the release of opposition detainees and adherence to constitutional timelines, have been made to prevent further escalation. The international community places significant emphasis on respecting democratic principles, human rights, and stability in the West African region. Recent clashes between security forces and opposition supporters have heightened these concerns, with international observers urging a peaceful resolution to the crisis. International observers have raised several specific concerns regarding the situation in Senegal. These concerns may include the postponement of elections, the treatment of opposition detainees, adherence to constitutional timelines, and the overall state of democratic principles and human rights in the country. Now, let's talk about ECOWAS actions. Has it failed to do its job? Recently, three West African nations, Niger, Mali, and Burkina Faso, recently decided to withdraw from the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS. Their reasoning behind this drastic move was a strong indictment against ECOWAS, accusing the regional organization of failing to fulfill its duties, particularly in protecting the interests of member nations and ensuring mutual benefits. Adding to the complexity, the situation in Senegal has further highlighted the challenges facing ECOWAS. as the organization has chosen to withdraw from intervening in the unfolding crisis. This raises important questions about ECOWAS's effectiveness and ability to promptly address regional issues. The withdrawal of three nations from ECOWAS was a rare and significant event, sending shockwaves across the region. The central criticism levied against ECOWAS was its perceived failure to execute its responsibilities, especially in safeguarding the interests and promoting the well-being of member states. Niger, Mali, and Burkina Faso, in their joint announcement, expressed dissatisfaction with ECOWAS's inability to respond adequately to the evolving challenges in the region. These challenges range from security threats to economic concerns, and the three nations felt that ECOWAS had fallen short in addressing their specific needs. This withdrawal serves as a wake-up call, forcing ECOWAS to reevaluate its strategies and effectiveness in meeting the diverse requirements of its member nations. In a curious twist, following the withdrawal of the three nations, ECOWAS chose to step back from intervening in the escalating crisis in Senegal. This move has intensified the scrutiny of ECOWAS's credibility and commitment to maintaining regional stability. Senegal, a region facing increasing unrest and potential humanitarian crises, needed the support and intervention of ECOWAS. However, the organization's decision to withdraw from involvement in Senegal has raised concerns about its ability to promptly address and resolve complex issues. The withdrawal of Niger, Mali, and Burkina Faso from ECOWAS now appears to be justified in light of ECOWAS's passive response to the Senegal situation. The collective decision of the three nations to distance themselves from an organization they perceived as ineffective now seems prescient. ECOWAS, as a regional bloc, was established to promote economic integration, peace, and security in West Africa. However, recent events have raised doubts about its capacity to fulfill these objectives. The withdrawal of the three nations and ECOWAS's subsequent withdrawal from Senegal indicate a systemic issue that requires urgent attention and reform within the organization. To comprehend the root causes of the recent withdrawals and ECOWAS's hesitance to intervene in Senegal, it's crucial to examine the organization's failures and shortcomings. ECOWAS has struggled to address internal conflicts within its member states effectively. While it has made efforts to mediate disputes, the outcomes have often been less than satisfactory, and in some instances, the conflicts have escalated further. The withdrawal of the three nations specifically highlighted concerns about ECOWAS's inability to ensure the security of member states. With rising security threats in the region, member nations expect a more robust and proactive response from the organization. ECOWAS was founded to foster economic integration among member states. However, disparities in economic development, trade barriers, and insufficient coordination have hindered progress. The organization's response to regional crises often appears disjointed and lacks a cohesive strategy. Member nations have expressed frustration over the lack of unity and coordination within ECOWAS. The recent developments necessitate a comprehensive reassessment of ECOWAS's structure, policies, and operational mechanisms. Rebuilding trust among member nations and enhancing the organization's effectiveness will be crucial for its continued relevance and success. ECOWAS needs to undertake significant operational reforms to streamline its decision-making processes, improve coordination, and ensure a more rapid response to emerging crises. This could involve establishing specialized task forces and a more agile decision-making framework. Strengthening ECOWAS's capacity for conflict prevention and resolution is paramount. Investing in diplomatic initiatives, early warning systems, and peacekeeping capabilities will contribute to a more proactive approach to managing internal conflicts. Enhancing security cooperation among member states is essential for addressing common threats. ECOWAS should facilitate sharing intelligence, joint military exercises, and collaborative efforts to combat transnational security challenges. Addressing economic disparities and trade barriers requires a renewed commitment to economic integration. ECOWAS should prioritize initiatives that promote fair trade, infrastructure development, and the removal of obstacles hindering economic cooperation. To regain the trust of member nations and the broader West African public, ECOWAS should prioritize transparency and engagement. Regular consultations with member states and civil society organizations can foster a sense of ownership and inclusivity. Do you think ECOWAS is useless? Should nations stay in it? What would happen if more nations left? Was Niger, Mali, and Burkina Faso's decision right? Let us know in the comment section if they should end ECOWAS. Do you want to watch more videos like this one? If yes, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon next to it. We have decided to bring videos on something nobody talks about, the Black culture, civilization, history, and evidence about how glorious Blacks have been. Thanks for watching, and until the next video, stay tuned.